Dear brothers and sisters, on this most sacred night, in which our Lord Jesus Christ passed over from death to life, the Church calls upon her sons and daughters, scattered throughout the world, to come together to watch and pray. If we keep the memorial of the Lord's Paschal solemnity in this way, listening to his word and celebrating his mysteries, then we shall have the sure hope of sharing his triumph over death and living with him in God. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who through your Son bestowed upon the faithful the fire of your glory, sanctify this new fire, we pray, and grant that by these Paschal celebrations we may be so inflamed with heavenly desires that with minds made pure we may attain the feast of eternal light. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Christ, yesterday and today, the beginning and the end, the Alpha and the Omega, all time belongs to him and all the ages. To him be glory and power through every age, forever and ever. May the light of Christ rising in glory dispel the darkness of our hearts and minds.
Exalt, let them exalt the host of heaven. Exalt, let angel ministers of God exalt. Let the trumpet of salvation sound aloud our mighty King's triumph. Be glad, let earth be glad as glory floods her, ablaze with light from her eternal King. Let all corners of the earth be glad, knowing an end to gloom and darkness. Rejoice, let Mother Church also rejoice, arrayed with the lighting of his glory. Let this holy building shake with joy, filled with the mighty voices of the peoples. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, with ardent love of mind and heart, and with devoted service of our voice, to acclaim our God invisible, the Almighty Father, and Jesus Christ our Lord, his Son, his only begotten, who for our sake paid Adam's debt to the eternal Father, and pouring out his own dear blood, wiped clean the record of our ancient sinfulness. These then are the feasts of Passover, in which is slain the Lamb, the one true Lamb, whose blood anoints the doorposts of believers. This is the night.
This is the night.
This is the night when once you led our forebears, Israel's children, from slavery in Egypt, and made them pass dry shod through the Red Sea. This is the night.
This is the night.
This is the night that with a pillar of fire banished the darkness of sin. This is the night.
This is the night.
This is the night that even now throughout the world sets Christian believers apart from worldly vices and from the gloom of sin, leading them to grace and joining them to his holy ones. This is the night. This is the night when Christ broke the prison bars of death and rose victorious from the underworld. Our birth would have been no gain had we not been redeemed. Wonder of your humble care for us, O love, O charity beyond all telling, to ransom a slave, you gave away your son. O truly necessary sin of Adam, destroyed completely by the death of Christ. Oh, happy fault that earned so great, so glorious a Redeemer. This is the night. At night, worthy alone to know the time and hour when Christ rose from the underworld. This is the night.
This is the night.
This is the night of which it is written, the night shall be as bright as day. Dazzling is the night for me and full of gladness. The sanctifying power of this night dispels wickedness, washes faults away, restores innocence to the fallen, and joy to mourners, drives out hatred, fosters concord, and brings down the mighty. This is the night. On this, your night of grace, O Holy Father, accept this candle, a solemn offering, the work of bees and of your servants' hands, an evening sacrifice of praise, this gift from your most holy church. But now we know the praises of this pillar, which glowing fire ignites for God's honor, a fire into many flames divided, yet never dimmed by sharing of its light. For it is fed by melting wax, drawn out by mother bees to build a torch so precious. This is the night.
This is the night.
Oh, truly blessed night, when things of heaven are wed to the earth and divine to the human. Therefore, O Lord, we pray you that this candle, hallowed to the honor of your name, may persevere undimmed to overcome the darkness of this night. This is the night.
This is the night.
Receive it as a pleasing fragrance and let it mingle with the lights of heaven. May this flame be found still burning by the morning star, the one morning star who never sets, Christ, your own Son, who coming back from death's domain has shed his peaceful light on humankind and lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen. Please blow out your candles and be seated. We have just sung the Exalted, that magnificent hymn to the light of the risen Christ. We now turn our attention to the scriptural witness that lays the foundation for our joy and hope. Let us now open our hearts to the beauty of the Bible's message as we listen to the creation story, the Exodus, and the prophet Isaiah. Let the words of one reading after another wash over us. Of course, the real beauty of the Bible is when it changes us as listeners, so that we live beautiful lives of faithfulness and service.
A reading from Genesis. In the beginning, when God created the heavens and the earth was formless void, and darkness covered the face of the deep. While a wind from God swept the face of the waters, then God said, "Let there be light," and there was light. And God saw that light was good. And God separated the light from the darkness. God called the light day, and the darkness he called night. And there was evening, and there was morning, the first day. And God said, "Let there be a dome in the midst of the waters, and let it separate the waters from the waters." So God made the dome and separated the waters that were under the dome from the waters that were above the dome. And it was so. God called the dome sky, and there was evening, and there was morning, the second day. And God said, "Let the waters under the sky be gathered together into one place, and let the dry land appear." And it was so. God called the dry land earth, and the waters that were gathered together he called seas. And God saw that it was good. Then God said, "Let the earth put forth vegetation, plants yielding seed, and fruit trees of every kind on the earth that bear fruit with the seed in it." And it was so. The earth brought forth vegetation, plants yielding seed of every kind, and trees of every kind bearing fruit with the seed in it. And God saw that it was good. And there was evening, and there was morning, the third day. And God said, "Let there be lights in the dome of the sky to separate the day from the night, and let them be for signs and for seasons and for days and years. And let them be lights in the dome of the sky to give light upon the earth." And it was so. God made the two great lights, the greater light to rule the day, and the lesser light to rule the night and the stars. God set them in the dome of the sky to give light upon the earth, to rule over the day and over the night, and to separate the light from the darkness. And God saw that it was good. And there was evening, and there was morning, the fourth day. And God said, let the waters bring forth swarms of living creatures, and let birds fly above the earth across the dome of the sky. So God created every living creature that moves, of every kind, with which the waters swarm, and every winged bird of every kind, and God saw that it was good. God blessed them, saying, be fruitful, multiply, and fill the waters in the seas, and let the birds multiply on the earth. And there was evening, and there was morning, the fifth day. And God said, let the earth bring forth living creatures of every kind, cattle and creeping things and wild animals of the earth of every kind. And it was so. God made the wild animals of the earth of every kind, and the cattle of every kind, and everything that creeps upon the ground of every kind. And God saw that it was good. Then God said, let us make humankind in our image, according to our likeness, and let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the birds of the air, and over the cattle, and over all the wild animals of the earth, and every creeping thing that creeps upon the earth. So God created humankind in his image. In the image of God, he created them. Male and female, he created them. God blessed them, and God said to them, be fruitful, and multiply, and fill the earth and subdue it, and have dominion over the fish and the sea, and over the birds of the air, and over everything that moves upon the earth. God said, see, I have given you every plant yielding seed that is upon the face of all the earth, and every tree with seed in its fruit, you shall have them for food. And every beast of the earth, and every bird of the air, and to everything that creeps on the earth, everything that has the breath of life, I have given every green plant for food. And it was so. God saw everything that he had made, and indeed, it was very good. And there was evening, and there was morning, the sixth day. Thus the heavens and the earth were finished, and all their multitude. And on the seventh day, God finished the work that he had done. And he rested on the seventh day from all the work that he had done.
Wisdom, you have made them whole. The earth is full of your riches. Bless the Lord, my soul. Lord, send out your spirit and renew the face of the earth.
O God, who wonderfully created human nature and still more wonderfully redeemed it, grant us, we pray, to set ourselves against the enticements of sin, that we may be graced with eternal joy. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Genesis. After these things, God tested Abraham. He said to Abraham, and he said, "Here I am." He said, "Take your son, your only son, Isaac, whom you love, and go to the land of Moriah and offer him there as a burnt offering on one of the mountains that I shall show you." So Abraham rose early in the morning, saddled his donkey, and took two of his young men with him and his son Isaac. He cut the wood for the burnt offering and set out and went to the place in the distance that God had shown him. On the third day, Abraham looked up and saw the place far away. Then Abraham said to his young man, "Stay here with the donkey. The boy and I will go over there. We will worship, and then we will come back to you." Abraham took the wood of the burnt offering and laid it on his son Isaac, and he himself carried the fire and the knife. So the two of them walked on together. Isaac said to his father Abraham, "Father," and he said, "Here I am, my son." He said, "The fire and wood are here, but where is the lamb for the burnt offering?" Abraham said, "God himself will provide the lamb for a burnt offering, my son." So the two of them walked on together. When they came to the place that God had shown him, Abraham built an altar there and laid the wood in order. He bound his son Isaac and laid him on the altar on top of the wood. Then Abraham reached out his son and took the knife to kill his son. But the angel of the Lord called to him from heaven and said, "Abraham, Abraham." And he said, "Here I am." He said, "Do not lay your hand on the boy or do anything to him. For now I know that you fear God, since you have not withheld your son, your only son, from me." And Abraham looked up and saw a ram caught in the thicket by its thorns. Abraham went and took the ram and offered it up as a burnt offering instead of his son. So Abraham called that place, "The Lord will provide." As it is said to this day, "On the mount of the Lord it shall be provided." The angel of the Lord called to Abraham a second time from heaven and said, "By myself I have sworn, says the Lord, because you have done this and have not withheld your son, your only son, I will indeed bless you, and I will make your offspring as numerous as the stars of heaven and as the sand on the seashore. And your offspring shall possess the gate of their enemies. And by your offspring shall all the nations of the earth gain blessing for themselves, because you have obeyed my voice." So Abraham returned to his young men, and they arose and went together to Beersheba. And Abraham lived at Beersheba.
O God, supreme Father of the faithful, who increased the children of your promise by pouring out the grace of adoption throughout the whole world, and who through the paschal mystery make your servant Abraham father of nations, as once you promised, grant that your peoples may enter worthily into the grace to which you call them, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Exodus. The Lord said to Moses, "Why do you cry out to me? Tell the Israelites to go forward, but you lift your staff and stretch out your hand over the sea and divide it, that the Israelites may go into the sea on dry ground. Then I will harden the hearts of the Egyptians so that they will go in after them. And so I will gain glory for myself over Pharaoh and all of his army, his chariots and his chariot drivers. And the Egyptians shall know that I am the Lord when I have gained glory for myself over Pharaoh, his chariots and his chariot drivers." The angel of God, who was going before the Israelite army, moved and went behind them. And the pillar of cloud moved from in front of them and took its place behind them. It came between the army of Egypt and the army of Israel. And so the cloud was there with the darkness, and it lit up the night. One did not come near the other all night. Then Moses stretched out his hand over the sea. The Lord drove the sea back by a strong east wind and turned the sea into dry land, and the waters were divided by. The Israelites went into the sea on dry ground, the waters forming a wall for them on their right and on their left. The Egyptians pursued and went into the sea after them, all of Pharaoh's horses, chariots, and chariot drivers. At the morning watch, the Lord in the pillar of fire and cloud looked down upon the Egyptian army and threw the Egyptian army into panic. He clogged their chariot wheels so that they turned with difficulty. The Egyptians said, "Let us flee from the Israelites, for the Lord is fighting for them against Egypt." Then the Lord said to Moses, "Stretch out your hand over the seas, that the water may come back upon the Egyptians, upon their chariots and their chariot drivers." So Moses stretched out his hand over the sea. And at dawn, the sea returned to its normal depth. As the Egyptians fled before it, the Lord tossed the Egyptians into the sea. The waters returned and covered the chariots and the chariot drivers. The entire army of Pharaoh that had followed them into the sea, not one of them remained. But the Israelites walked on dry ground through the sea, the waters forming a wall for them on their right and on their left. Thus the Lord saved Israel that day from the Egyptians, and Israel saw the Egyptians dead on the seashore. Israel saw the great work that the Lord did against the Egyptians, so the people feared the Lord and served and his servant Moses. Then Moses and the Israelites sang this song before the Lord.
Thank you.
O God, whose ancient wonders remain undimmed in the splendor even in our day, for what you once bestowed on a single people, grant that the whole world may become children of Abraham and inherit the dignity of Israel's birthright. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
From the prophet Isaiah. For your Maker is your husband. The Lord of hosts is his name. The Holy One of Israel is your Redeemer. The God of the whole earth he is called. For the Lord has called you, like a wife forsaken and grieved in spirit, like the wife of a man's youth when she is cast off, says your God. For a brief moment I abandoned you, but with great compassion I will gather you. In overflowing wrath for a moment, I hid my face from you. But with everlasting love, I will have compassion on you, says the Lord, your Redeemer. This is like the days of Noah to me. Just as I swore that the waters of Noah would never again go over all the earth, so I have sworn that I will not be angry with you and will not rebuke you. For the mountains may depart and the hills be removed, but my steadfast love shall not depart from you, and my covenant of peace shall not be removed, says the Lord, who has compassion on you. O afflicted one, storm-tossed and not comforted, I am about to set your stones in antimony and lay foundations with sapphires. I will make your pinnacles of rubies, your gates of jewels, and all your wall of precious stones. All your children shall be taught by the Lord, and great shall be the prosperity of your children. In righteousness you shall be established. You shall be far from oppression, for you shall not fear, and from terror, for it shall not come near you. If anyone stirs up strife, it is not from me. Whoever stirs up strife with you shall fall because of you.
I will pray. there are tears, but joy comes with dawn.
Almighty, ever-living God, surpass for the honor of your name what you pledged to the patriarchs by reason of their faith, and through sacred adoption increase the children of your promise, so that if the saints of old never doubted would come to pass, your church may now see in great part fulfilled. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
From the prophet Isaiah. O everyone who thirsts, come to the waters. And you that have no money, come, buy and eat. Come, buy wine and milk without money and without price. Why do you spend your money for that which is not bread? And your labor for that which does not satisfy. Listen carefully to me, and eat what is good, and delight yourselves in rich food. Incline your ear and come to me. Listen so that you may live. I will make with you an everlasting covenant. My steadfast, sure love for David. See, I made him a witness to the peoples, a leader and commander for the peoples. See, you shall call nations that you do not know, and nations that do not know you shall run to you because of the Lord your God, the Holy One of Israel, for he has glorified you. Seek the Lord while he may be found. Call upon him while he is near. Let the wicked forsake their way, and the unrighteous their thoughts. Let them return to the Lord, that he may have mercy on them, and to our God, for he will abundantly pardon. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, nor are your ways my ways, says the Lord. For as the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts than your thoughts. For as the rain and snow come down from heaven and do not return there until they have watered the earth, making it spring forth and sprout, giving seed to the sower and bread to the eater, so shall my word be that goes out from my mouth. It shall not return to me empty, but it shall accomplish that which I purpose, and succeed in the thing for which I sent it.
Almighty ever-living God, sole hope of the world, who by the preaching of your prophets unveiled the mysteries of this present age, graciously increase the longing of your people, for only at the prompting of your grace do the faithful progress in any kind of virtue. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
From the prophet Baruch. Hear the commandments of life, O Israel. Give ear and learn wisdom. Why is it, O Israel, why is it that you are in the land of your enemies, that you are growing old in a foreign country, that you are defiled with the dead, that you are counted among those in Hades? You have forsaken the fountain of wisdom. If you had walked in the way of God, you would be living in peace forever. Learn where there is wisdom, where there is strength, where there is understanding, so that you may at the same time discern where there is days and length of life, where there is light for the eyes and peace. Who has found her place? And who has entered her storehouses? But the one who knows all things knows her. He has found her by his understanding. The one who prepared the earth for all time, filled it with four-footed creatures. The one who sends forth the light and it goes. He called it, and it obeyed him, trembling. The stars shone in their watches and were glad. He called them, and they said, "Here we are." They shone with gladness for him who made them. This is our God. No other can be compared to him. He found the whole way to knowledge and gave her to his servant Jacob and to Israel, whom he loved. Afterward, she appeared on earth and lived with humankind. She is the book of the commandments of God, the law that endures forever. All who hold her fast will live, and those who forsake her will die. Turn, O Jacob, and take her. Walk toward the shining of her light. Do not give your glory to another or your advantages to an alien people. Happy are we, O Israel, for we know what is pleasing to God.
O God, who constantly increase your church by your call to the nations, graciously grant that those who wash in the waters of baptism the assurance of your unfailing protection. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
From the prophet Ezekiel. The word of the Lord came to me. Mortal, when the house of Israel lived on their own soil, they defiled it with their ways and their deeds. So I poured out my wrath upon them for the blood that they had shed upon the land and for the idols with which they had defiled it. I scattered them among the nations, and they were dispersed through the countries. In accordance with their conduct and their deeds, I judged them. But when they came to the nations, wherever they came, they profaned my holy name, in that it was said of them, "These are the people of the Lord," and yet they had to go out of his land. But I had concern for my holy name, which the house of Israel had profaned among the nations to which they came. Therefore, say to the house of Israel, thus says the Lord God, it is not for your sake, O house of Israel, that I am about to act, but for the sake of my holy name, which you have profaned among the nations to which you came. I will sanctify my great name, which has been profaned among the nations, and which you have profaned among them, and the nations shall know that I am the Lord, says the Lord God, when through you I display my holiness before their eyes. I will take you from the nations and gather you from all the countries and bring you into your own land. I will sprinkle clean water upon you, and you shall be clean from all your uncleannesses, and from all your idols I will cleanse you. A new heart I will give you, and a new spirit I will put within you. And I will remove from your body the heart of stone and give you a heart of flesh. I will put my spirit within you and make you follow my statutes and be careful to observe my ordinances. Then you shall live in the land that I gave to your ancestors, and you shall be my people, and I will be your God.
O God, by the pages of both testaments, instruct and prepare us to celebrate the Paschal mystery. Grant that we may embrace your mercy, so that the gifts we receive from you this night may confirm our hope of the gifts to come. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you.
Let us pray. O God, who make this most sacred night radiant with the glory of the Lord's resurrection, stir up in your church a spirit of adoption, so that, renewed in body, mind, and heart, we may render you undivided service. To our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. From the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Do you not know that all of us who have been baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? Do you not know that all of us who have been baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? Therefore, we have been buried with him by baptism into death, so that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, so we too might walk in newness of life. For if we have been united with him in a death like his, we will certainly be united with him in a resurrection like his. We know that our old self was crucified with him, so that the body of sin might be destroyed, and we might no longer be enslaved to sin. For whoever has died is freed from sin. But if we have died with Christ, we believe that we will also live with him. We know that Christ, being raised from the dead, will never die again. Death no longer has dominion over him. The death he died to sin once for all. But the life he lives to God. So you also must consider yourselves dead to sin and alive to God in Christ Jesus.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O
When the Sabbath was over, Mary Magdalene, Mary the mother of James, and Salome bought spices so that they might go and anoint him. Very early when the sun had risen, on the first day of the week, they came to the tomb. They were saying to one another, "Who will roll back the stone for us from the entrance to the tomb?" When they looked up, they saw that the stone had been rolled back. It was very large. On entering the tomb, they saw a young man sitting on the right side, clothed in a white robe, and they were utterly amazed. He said to them, "Do not be amazed. You seek Jesus of Nazareth, the crucified. He has been raised. He is not here. Behold the place where they laid him. But go and tell his disciples and Peter, he is going before you to Galilee. There you will see him as he told you." In song, let us proclaim the gospel of the Lord.
Tonight, as we gather in the sacred darkness of this Easter vigil, there was one additional verse to Mark's story of Jesus' resurrection that was omitted in that beautiful proclamation of our gospel. That verse says, "The women went out and fled from the tomb, for terror and amazement had seized them, and they said nothing to anyone, for they were afraid." This abrupt ending leaves us hanging with bewilderment. It highlights the drama of uncertainty over the fear and astonishment the three women experienced in their encounter with the young man sitting inside Jesus' tomb. In the Bible, Mark's gospel actually continues for another 11 verses with brief stories of the risen Jesus appearing to Mary Magdalene, to the 11 and the Ascension. But most biblical scholars believe that these were added to Mark's original text in the first and second centuries by well-meaning Christians who wanted to complete Mark's gospel with stories from the early church's rich oral tradition. But the writing style and themes of these added verses are foreign to everything else in Mark's gospel. So the oldest text we have of Mark's gospel ends with these haunting words: "They were afraid." Yet isn't that our reaction to the news of Jesus' resurrection? The new life of Easter scares us. It shakes us to our core. It demands that we confront uncomfortable truths in our lives. The resurrection of Jesus calls us out from the safe tombs we have created for ourselves, where we are alone with our vulnerabilities. And it invites us toward a new life strengthened by Christ's unconquerable compassion, forgiveness, and justice. God's raising Christ from the dead is a call for us to leave behind our self-centered purgatories and venture into the Galilees, where we identify and connect with the poor, the marginalized, the lost, and the despised. It calls us to let go of our fears and doubts and to allow ourselves to be transformed by the love of the risen Christ. So as we prepare to greet Easter morning, let us not be afraid to embrace the fear and uncertainty that comes with Christ's resurrection into new life. Let us step out of our tombs of complacency and dare to venture forth into a new life, guided by the light of Christ. For it is only in facing our fears and embracing the transformative power of resurrection that we will truly experience the peace and joy of the new life of Easter. Through this Eucharist, may we receive the grace and courage to be joined to the new life of the risen Christ as we abandon the tombs we have created for ourselves and bring the good news of resurrection to our Galilees.
for the renewal of the baptismal promises, the abbot and the ministers will process to the baptismal font. Please turn towards the font for the blessing of the water and the renewal. Please stand.
O God, who by invisible power accomplish a wondrous effect through the sacramental signs, and who in many ways have prepared water for your creation to show forth the grace of baptism. O God, whose Spirit in the first moments of the world's creation hovered over the waters, so that the very substance of water would even then take to itself the power to sanctify. O God, who by the outpouring of the flood foreshadowed regeneration, so that from the mystery of the one and same element of water would come an end to vice and a beginning of virtue. O God, who caused the children of Abraham to pass dryshod through the Red Sea, so that the chosen people, set free from slavery to Pharaoh, would prefigure the people of the baptized. O God, whose Son, baptized by John in the waters of the Jordan, was anointed with the Holy Spirit, and as he hung upon the cross, gave forth water from his side along with blood, and after his resurrection commanded his disciples, "Go forth, teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit." Look now, we pray, upon the face of your church, and graciously unseal for her the fountain of baptism. May this water receive by the Holy Spirit the grace of your only begotten Son, so that human nature, created in your image and washed clean through the sacrament of baptism from all the squalor of old, may be found worthy to rise to the life of newborn children through the water and the Holy Spirit. May the power of the Holy Spirit, O Lord, we pray, come down through your Son into the fullness of this font, so that all who have been buried with Christ by baptism into death may rise again to life with him who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Dear brothers and sisters, through the Paschal mystery, we have been buried with Christ in baptism so that we may walk with him in newness of life. And so now that our Lenten observance is concluded, let us renew the promises of holy baptism by which we once renounced Satan and his works and promised to serve God in the Holy Catholic Church. Please respond, I do. Do you renounce sin so as to live in the freedom of the children of God?
I do.
Do you renounce the lure of evil so that sin may have no mastery over you?
I do.
Do you renounce Satan, the author and prince of sin?
I do.
Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth?
I do.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, suffered death and was buried, rose again from the dead, and is seated at the right hand of the Father?
I do.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting?
I do.
And may Almighty God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has given us new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, and bestowed on us forgiveness of our sins, keep us by his grace, in Christ Jesus our Lord, for eternal life. Amen.
Amen.
In the one salvation, everlasting love.
Springs of
Lord God, you did not forget your beloved Son in death, but raised him to life on the third day. In his most sacred name, we ask you to answer our prayers. Let us share the joy of heaven today and every day, both now and forever. On this festival day, let us present our petitions to the Almighty God through Jesus Christ, our life and resurrection.
That the Church will rejoice in Christ's triumph over sin and death, let us pray to the Lord. That all who are baptized or received in full communion to the Catholic Church this night will rejoice in peace from on high. Let us pray to the Lord. That the nations of the world will rejoice in deliverance from war and from every threat to human life, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our
prayer. That those who have died will rejoice forever in glory with their risen Savior, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
Lord God, you did not forget your beloved Son in death, but raised him to life on the third day. In his most sacred name, we ask you to answer our prayers. Let us share the joy of heaven today and every day, both now and forever.
Amen.
Our collection, both in church and online, will go for the support of Central Minnesota Habitat for Humanity.
Sing Alleluia, sing Alleluia, sing Alleluia.
Thank you.
Let us pray, my brothers and sisters, that our sacrifice will be made acceptable to God, our Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands. Praise.
Accept, we ask, O Lord, the prayers of your people with the sacrificial offerings, that what has begun in the Paschal mysteries may, by the working of your power, bring us to the healing of eternity through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but on this night above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying he has destroyed our death, and by rising restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Sanctus, sanctus, sanctus.
Gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, were nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, St. John the Baptist, Saints Benedict and Scholastica, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Patrick, our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Behold, this is the Lamb of God. This is he who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are all who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Yeah.
sing alleluia, oh sing, sing alleluia, oh sing alleluia, oh sing alleluia.
Sing alleluia, 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 oh sing alleluia, come let us sing a joyful alleluia, alleluia, oh sing alleluia, joyfully sing alleluia, oh sing, sing alleluia, oh sing alleluia. Oh, sing alleluia, 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 alleluia.
Let us pray. Pour out on us, O Lord, the spirit of your love, and in your kindness, make those you have nourished by this paschal sacrament one in mind and heart, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
In the name of the St. John's monastic community, I wish you a most blessed and happy Easter. After this liturgy, you are invited to the Great Hall for some refreshments before you make your way home. The Lord be with you.
Let us bow our heads and pray for God's blessings.
May Almighty God bless you through today's Easter solemnity and in his compassion defend you from every sin.
Amen.
May he who restores you to eternal life in the resurrection of his only begotten, endow you with the prize of immortality.
Amen.
Now that the days of the Lord's Passion have drawn to a close, may you who celebrate the gladness of the Paschal Feast come with Christ's help and exalting in spirit to the feast which lasts forever.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Go in peace. Alleluia. Alleluia.